So, as we begin 2022, we've shortlisted the best project management applications of the year ahead. These are some great all-rounders, and we're really excited in today's video to dive into each of them. Now, our search criteria for this experience has been portability, where you can get it on all of your different devices, the views in terms of the alternating views you get with this applications, and also the reliability that has been on the market with these applications. Now let's start with monday.com, a super popular application, which is no doubt you've had an advert from them before. They've been on the market for some time now. I actually got over to Tel Aviv to meet the team, really friendly, and they seem to be working really hard on developing the application in a high level of detail. Now, monday.com has a range of flexible views, which is a feature a lot of people like inside of their project management. And actually, inside this application, you can change it into a variety of views. But I think one thing that people like most is the nature, the simple nature that this application has got from day one. So you could pretty much sign up and get started with it, mainly because it really looks like a spreadsheet, but a much cleaner spreadsheet from the start. And then you can express different views and learn about the applications on the go. This application also has some really powerful automations that can really be leveraged if you've got some integrations that you're looking to sort of embed within your application, whether that's connecting it to Slack or another application that you have in mind. It's got a range of them, which is great in particular for making sure that you're connecting your experiences together. Now, monday.com also has a range of templates, which are great to get started on too. So next up is Asana, and this is always been popular with marketing and sales team. Asana has actually been in the market for ages, and it was actually created by Dustin Moskovitz, the co-founder of Facebook. But it has been a long-standing application that a lot of people love and use on a daily basis. Now, inside of Asana, there's a great range of views. You do have boards and timeline, but comparably to other applications, they don't necessarily have as many, but it is also super popular with the integrations. It's probably got one of the wildest, sort of most large library of integrations in the project management space. And it also does have a fantastic YouTube channel that every month, much like many of the others, dives into what's new with the application. And I believe in their last update, they actually added some improvements to the My Tasks view, which allows you to see your own personal tasks. Talking about personal tasks, our next project manager is ClickUp. Now, ClickUp has been around a little bit less than Asana and Monday, but they have been very popular in the last couple of years. Now, ClickUp has a wide variety of views, allowing you to chop and change the way that you see data. But it also has a fairly different experience called Docs. And this allows you to essentially create a document and collaborate with other people. So very much similar to Notion and to some extent in creating a little wiki experience inside of your account. And they've had that for a little bit of time now. It's also got a personal view as well, which is perfect for if you're using this as a solo application and you don't necessarily want to commit to investing your whole team in, you can play around with it yourself. And it's also, as you can imagine, quite feature heavy. They add new features on a pretty regular basis. So next up is Trello. And you've probably heard of Trello because it is, much like Asana, a very well-known application in the space. It's run by a company called Atlassian, as they acquired them a few years ago now. Now, the team are really focused on sort of building an application that has a really powerful nature behind its sort of very simplistic setup. Many people know that Trello has board view, but they've recently been adding a few more views. Although they're a little bit behind in that department when it comes to views, they have added table, calendar, and they're looking to add more views soon. It also has a really powerful function called butler automations and also power-ups that allow you to connect other applications and sort of have mini apps working inside of your Trello boards to do certain things when you activate specific workflows, which is super interesting, and it's growing in popularity. Next up is Notion. Now, I was really worried about adding this as a project management application, but to be fair, it's really grown in the space as a project management application. It's being used by a wide variety of teams in a lot of different contexts, and people love the fact that it's more like wiki and projects in one location People love to capture all that siloed information, and more recently with their new API release, Notion has got much more powerful, allowing you to connect it with other applications that really do, you know, 10x your Notion account. Now, it does take a little bit of education to learn, it does take a little bit of time. So once you do learn it, it does give you the flexibility and the portability to really go and take it a lot further. So that's one thing you'll find and love inside of Notion. There is, for example, templates which people sell on the market, and there is a great course and experience that I'll link in the description called Notion Mastery about learning it to really optimize it for your team. So next up is a project manager called Wrike. Again, it's been around for a fair while and very popular in marketing and sales teams. It's also popular with management as well, with features inside of it for being able to organize team resources, and it really is a very easy experience to get started with. In terms of its look and layout, it's very much like applications like Teamwork and Hive, which we'll come to in a moment, that have been on the market for some time. Teamwork is much more of a recent application. They're developed in Ireland and they are really more focused towards agencies, but actually have the flexible nature to be available to pretty much anyone. It is much more of a traditional setup. You're not necessarily going to see some of the advanced views you see in ClickUp and Monday. However, it's got a great billable minute experience, so if you're working with a client, you can connect up and really work out how much time is being spent on specific projects or specific pieces of work. Moving on, Basecamp. This has been in the market for donkeys, and again, it's a really reliable experience. A lot of people love this for remote experiences and asynchronous, but it is a bit pricier. At $99 a month, it does come costly if you have a small team, but when you're using it for as many people as you like, you are still paying $99 per month. So the pricing actually works out if you're a larger team, and also you can also manage your own personal to-dos and calendar in there, which is quite a nice feature in my opinion. So next up is Hive, and we reviewed Hive a long time ago, and it's got some great chat ability in terms of being able to communicate with people in real time. It's also really well known for its timesheets and also team resource management. So you can, for example, plan and see what other team members are working on at any given time. It's also got a really neat focus mode so that you can block out any distractions and take away any websites that you are visiting on a regular basis. And finally, the final application on our list is a application called Paymo. And no, it's not a payment company. It allows you to manage your projects but also bill clients directly. It helps you to track your time, and it's more popular with those who are sort of very time orientated, who work with clients, or maybe even who work and bill their time online directly. It is more of a tool that is orientated towards that analysis. You can also go much deeper with reports. Well, we will definitely do a review on it here on the channel. So in 2020, I reckon that the focus will be much more on machine learning pulling more of the weight. I think being able to sort of connect your applications that you may other work with, and it to be able to start doing more of the work behind the scenes for you, this is where project management applications are heading in the future. You can definitely follow more for more project management reviews here on Keep Productive. If you enjoyed today's video, you can subscribe and like, and also share what project management application that you currently use and are considering using in the comments below. Thank you very much, folks, and I hope you enjoyed today's video. Cheers!